This carne asada, check it out.
Wow. Chef Big Dog up all night cooking.
Shut up and taste this, a mousse douche. Come here, guys.
Look at that.
You like it?
Yeah.
We're gonna cook like this.
¿Qué pasa? ¿Cómo están, mi gente? I am Zay Zay, and welcome to another banging interview. Today, I have the privilege of sitting with a real, real good actor who didn't just find his way in this industry. He pretty much took it. I'm sitting with Jon Favreau. How you doing today, sir?
Very good.
All right. That's why I started it that way, because that's one of the things that I most admire about you and your career is that, you know, I had to branch out on your own. You had to go out, went out to Chicago, went out, started producing.
Yeah, sure.
I wasn't getting the roles I wanted, so I had to make them.
Yes.
Is that pretty much the cornerstone of even the way you think today?
It is. I like it. You know, I see it, well, now more than ever, you could do anything, because even when we made Swingers, you still had to raise a couple hundred grand to get the film and the cameras.
Right.
Now you could do it with a few bucks. You know, you get a 5D that could shoot video. You edit it on your laptop. It's a few grand.
Yeah.
So it's just a matter of how good you get. But to have, there's always going to be people who tell you you can't do it. There's always going to be people who tell you, even once you're doing it, how to do it. If you want to do it like this. And
okay.
And what was so fun about Chef was that it was me saying, I how little do I have to make a movie for to have zero input from the people who are providing the money? That I could write whatever I want, I could cast whoever I want, shoot it wherever I want, edit it however I want.
Right.
And so that was very nice after doing the big movies, where no matter how appreciated you are, you're still a cog in a bigger machine.
Sure.
There's
sure.
a lot of money on the line. And by the way, I don't resent it. I understand it. There's, you know, there's hundreds of millions of dollars when you think about, and a big brand that means a lot to a big corporation.
Right.
So you could be as artistic as you want, but you have to color within the lines.
Mm. Right.
Here there was no line. Here I drew the lines.
I love
you know?
It.
And so I got to follow whatever I was passionate about, whatever I had something to say. And it was about the food world, which I love, and about being a dad.
Right.
And me being in my 40s, what I've learned up to this point, and make a movie about real life and not about escapism or fantasy.
All right. Now, this movie, you wrote it, you directed it, you produced it, you starred in it.
Yeah.
Did you take any time? Did you schedule any, like, sleep, some
sitting
it's time, quick. Breathing?
It's quick, you know, because it's only a month. And I trained for a few months beforehand.
So
it was really a fun experience, because I love learning how to cook from great chefs and then bonding with the actors, because I was working with Leguizamo in rehearsals.
Mm-hmm.
So all of it was fun.
Reviews out.
His dramatic weight gain can only be explained by the fact that he must be eating all the food sent back to the kitchen.
It seems like not just a cooking movie or a movie about food, but also like a finding your purpose in life. That's what I took away from it.
I think
like,
that's more what it is. I think the cooking's fun, and the cooking is a relatively inexpensive way to have really beautiful production value and get everybody excited, because it's, you know, to me, the food looks as good as any explosion we have at Iron Man.
Sure.
It's just really captivating, if you like food.
If you don't like food,
it's probably not. It's probably a boring film. But if you like food, that part's fun. But it's really about the dad and the son connecting.
Sure.
After he hadn't spent a lot of time paying attention to his kid. He's divorced from the mom. He's too busy with his career. And that's where I thought I could really tell that story, from being a dad and also being a kid from a divorced family and remembering what that felt like. And I really understood both sides of it.
Yeah.
And to me, that was the fun. That, to me, that's really what the film is about. It's about finding your passion in life and balancing out what's important with your career.
Right.
And so that's that, at my age, at this stage in my career, that's the thing I felt that I had a lot to say about.
Well, I like Chef, and I like you, and I like
Thank
food.
You. Cheers. Thank you. All right.
Take care of yourself.
Care,
Thank you very much
Thank
for taking
you.
Your time.
I was so jealous when I heard your voice. I was like, that's what I want to do.
I get to touch people's lives with what I do, and I love it. And I want to share this with you.
Why do
thinking of putting a little cornstarch on my werewolves, man. It's too humid down here.
Dad, wake up. Frank's putting cornstarch on his balls.
Want some? It's like baby powder. It's nice, right?
Nice.
Gente de zona, una vez más.